Welcome to Watercolor Wednesday at the Church of the Palms in Sarasota, Florida. I am Kathy Futrell, and today we're going to do a watercolor based on the design of leaves. Here we are in the fall. So I give you an example here of one that I have finished, and sometimes you can look at photographs to get your inspiration of all these colors. Here is another little example. Actually, this is the one that inspired me to do the watercolor painting here. But I also know that the design can be based on a single leaf drawing, or if you wanted to get really carried away, you could take all the different types of leaves, oak leaves, maple leaves. I know this is a poplar tree. I don't know what that one would be. But anyway, while we were up in the mountains of North Carolina, I did find various leaves. They were, before they turned brown, reds and oranges. Oh, here's one that actually is still red. And beautiful purples and yellows and greens. So this is how I'm going to base my design today. And I'm going to quickly sketch a composition and do a watercolor rendering. Now, after I, if you wish to take your own leaves, or if you would like to, say, draw a design of overlapping leaf shapes, you could do it that way. Every time I think about something in this direction, I always try to think about where is my focal point. And I consider that the rule of thirds. So I have put this is a horizontal. If my design were going vertical, which it doesn't matter which way you want to go, I try to start with, just as we did with the seashells, I try to start with a shape that's my dominant shape. So obviously, this would be using the point here as my focal point, because this shape is going to dominate because of its size, and especially if I wanted to go bright in color. Now, just to save time, I am going to do a quick trace, and as you may know, that's perfectly legit to get your design started. And then I'm going to do not all of the leaf designs that I draw, but enough to kind of get you going. All right, so the stem can be extended and drawn to give the effect, and this is, and I do observe the veins that are extending from this central point. And I do them very lightly because I will come back and do that with a watercolor. The other leaves, I can exaggerate those shapes, or I could place them behind. So I'm just sort of looking at this one instead of tracing it. And I really can now observe. I like to run things off the page. And you can work any size. If you're working on this watercolor for 2 weeks or multiple days, you could be a huge sheet of paper. I might even repeat this leaf shape over here. And again, it's kind of focused on thinking about, well, let me decide where else I'm going to put that one. Let's go with this poplar leaf over here. And I could just sort of move it to that edge, and I like touching other shapes. And again, this gets to go behind, and this has a similar point with a vein down the center, and I could just set it off to the side. Now, I could choose to go behind or in front. I think it looks best behind, and just getting a few suggestions of the veins. Maybe I'm going to repeat this one over here. Maybe I need a maple leaf. Oh, and this one's really quite sweet to sketch. The maple leaf, I want to turn it in the direction of my focal point. And sometimes, here's what I sometimes do. I sometimes just go get the basic shape, and then I come back and do my little jagged edge here. So there is that basic shape. And then I can leave this here to study and place my vein and come along. That's actually, this leaf is sort of broken, but I can mend my leaf shape just by drawing the line more correctly as the leaf had once been. Okay. So now I've got my little jagged edge that represents this leaf, and doing my lines. And I need a few more leaves in here to complete the design. And I just have to decide, I basically only have three or four different. I thought maybe what I need to do is put some smaller shapes in so I don't compete too much with that maple, oak leaf. So I'll get this one, and it does have a jagged edge, but I'll complete that later. And I want a different size. This looks like the same one I just did, doesn't it? Oh, I probably did trace. So here I have just all these different leaf patterns. Some I've cut out of the more cardboardy paper. They're a little more durable, and then some white shapes. Well, this is pretty big shape here. Let me see. I want, that's another maple leaf. There's a little tiny one. I want small ones, so I want to have a variety of shapes. So I guess I'll do this one and see if that fills up my space a little bit better. All right, so we're back to the sketch and getting ready to do the watercolor. I'm going to place this maple and this leaf right here. Okay, I think that'll complete my design. Now, if you'll forgive me, I'm just going to start painting. Pretend, well, I can get just the basic shapes here. And sometimes, even when I'm at this process, I might decide to add a few more. All right. And again, I can use my stems to connect. That one goes out. And I could do my detail. To begin with, I'm just going to start with some washes. And can you see some of the painting, some of my watercolor here? All right, so unfortunately, last time I painted, I didn't clean my palette. Please forgive me. But sometimes all you need to do is put a little water on it and you just go again. This oak leaf had a lot of red orange. And I'm going to begin with kind of capturing this shape. I think this is a number eight brush, just to kind of quickly get some strokes that suggest in a wash fashion. And I'm going those strokes in the direction of my veins. So, and these strokes are going off, and that's because the veins are going to really be pronounced as either a dark ridge or a lighter ridge. And sometimes your leaves, now I might just switch at this point, I'm working a little bit more with the red, and then just let these colors kind of run together. And don't be afraid to let this happen, because this is the way nature happens in the fall color leaves. This might also have, right now I'm not blending too much with my yellow and my red. As I move this through some of the yellow, I'll probably start to pick up a little bit more of the orange, like right there. And dry brush will help the effect, because that dry brush gives the indication of the texture that's on here. Now, I want to go a little bolder with this, but this is my first wash. And if you look at how I created these leaves, I started light, like I'm doing, and then I just kept building darker and darker. So this seems a little pale right now. This is where we have fun. Now, I might be a little adventurous right down here and add a bit of purple. I know I'm going to want a lot of color in all my leaves. Whether or not I choose to do anything in my background, right now I just thought I would leave the background as a white and just play with scooting the lines through, adding all my color to the leaves themselves. And after that dries, I'll do more layers and I'll do a calligraphy. So let me jump to this leaf, which I thought would be more of a brighter yellow. And I'll probably add some lines to it.
What is that yellow?
This one is my Bumblebee from American Journey Paint. But if you're using any CAD yellow medium, that would do it. any bright yellow. My lightest yellow is called Aurelian, and it's a transparent. This is a much more opaque paint. Good question. Don't hesitate to ask, because that's how we learn. You know, watercolor is a versatile, I don't like it that plain, so why not add a little bit of green? Because most of these leaves are transitioning in nature from that green color that they tend to be. And even by drawing the lines in here while it's wet, they'll fade, but they're still going to suggest what's going on with that leaf. So I already like the way that's turning out. I think I'm gonna have this one as also start with some yellow, because I'm thinking about the balance. And this could end up being yellow on one side, go a little bit more red-orange, and it could turn purple at the top. And remember, this is just the first wash. Maybe by the time I get a first wash, I'll be able to do a little detail here and you'll know how to proceed. What I like to do is try to finish up one of my paintings and send it to everybody on an email, because you can't really do the finish touch in a demo. So here's my purple. I'm just gonna go really strong here. As a matter of fact, I might just put a little bit of blue in here. And I feel like I'm being very gentle with these colors when I know I want to go get a little more exaggerated. Okay, that blue is kind of interesting to add. Just play, have fun, see what happens. This has got to get bolder and stronger. So I think this will be, you know, you can't really get away from the yellow and the reds and the oranges, because that's what leaves are going to be. But it is fun to throw in the purples and the blues, and maybe this one is gonna become much more orange. I actually have some orange here. But you can make your orange. If you don't have an orange, stick with your cad yellow and just put some rose madder or cadmium red right in. I have a red that's called Red Hot Mama. That's a nice name. And I also have this beautiful red that's more of this rose madder is what I call a pinker, a more of alizarin crimson. See, this red is a little different. But by the time I use any red with this yellow, I'm gonna get this gorgeous orange. Now this is getting a bit on the bold side. I think I'm gonna switch to a brush with water and just pull that color in the direction of the veins. There's so many ways to work with watercolor, wet and wet, and I'm basically doing only wash right now. But if you, let me just show you that technique. So if I wanted to do a wet and wet, I would add water to my leaf, and then I would just let that color run. Be careful when you have one leaf behind another that you don't touch that leaf so that they don't mingle together. Although I have seen artists be quite successful with doing that on purpose, as their design says, you know what, it doesn't matter. Now that's an area that's pretty dry. I'm gonna just drag that along. Isn't that kind of interesting? We're just sort of playing with how to put these lines in too. Okay, so then this leaf here is another, maybe that will be more of a green leaf. Let's see about mixing the yellow and the green. And I wanted to add that point, and that's what a round brush does. It allows you to make that point. So I hadn't really sketched those points. And again, I'm gonna sneak a little color in here. And for the stems, I want to talk about them. And I think I'm going to do a darker green, just a little darker green and yellow. And let it.
And that green is?
That green was a Viridian, but I really didn't clean my brush very well, so I think it was mixed with a bit of yellow. Okay. Thanks for reminding me that I need to talk about the colors. And I think I need a bit of a purple over here. So with this leaf, maybe this one will repeat some of the purple. Okay, quickly, I have everything covered. I want to say that was amethyst. It's called amethyst, and it's American Journey paint too. So I use a burnt sienna, which is a burnt dark reddish brown, and I take a little bit of that burnt sienna and I add it with a bit of cobalt blue, here's my cobalt, to make a gray, but I dominate with more of a warm color. It could have the orange in it or just simply more burnt sienna. So if I have a stem that I want to suggest in the design, and these are all, I think, gonna be a bit, this one has a touch of red on it. Look at that, red and purple. I don't hesitate. If I see it there, although I'm putting this in as a first little brown, I would not hesitate to come back and put some of that purple on there. Okay, so that, look at the musical feeling that you have just by doing that. So the next coat, I do play with darker colors and just keep on doing that next wash, allowing the paint to show through. And I'm just gonna do a little bit on one side, and then on this other side, I'm going to show you how I would add the lines. So one of your smaller brushes, you would want to do your calligraphy running through. I think I'm going to use more rose madder here, and it did have red down here, and then running that rose madder through the center and just suggesting. If I get a little heavy and I don't like something, I don't like the way it's looking right there, I just take a little water on my brush and I take a tissue or a paper towel and I soften that up. Didn't really like the way it was looking, so there, it's gone. Okay, I love to fix my mistakes, so we're all gonna do them. Here, I'm just gonna add my lines to suggest. And another thing that I really like to do is add a little splatter. Now, splatter is fun, but it can be dangerous to your painting. So you got to block areas. And so the best way to block is just to have a paper towel or a tissue or something where you can focus on putting a few pieces of paper to protect the white areas of your painting. And I think what I could do here is just stick this in that spot. And then I will take some stronger paint, something like the burnt sienna or the rose madder, and I'll just do a little flipping of the brush to get the spots. Of course, it's going over here instead of here. But that's the idea behind getting a little bit of color in your leaf with a little splatter. Okay, so you can see that that adds a bit of texture. You can also do, I've seen people lift and stipple and just continue a little bit of texture just with, I use anything, my fingers. I don't like my pencil line showing here, so I'm gonna put a lot more detail in this and a little bit darker as this goes along. And the lines that I see, if I can get that little tiny line, which I just accomplished there, softening up those edges, that's what I will do until I'm happy with the effect of my overall painting. So So this again is just a finished example, and just have fun with what you do. Thank you so much, and happy painting to all, and play with your leaves, make up your own design.